Can I at least make a statement first?
At the airport, no.
I think these people should know why you're pointing a gun at me. I think they should know who I am and what I did and why I did it.
This is another one of your tricks. Men, I'm not gonna let you fool me again like you did in that hotel room in LA. You're not gonna put on a show for these people.
A show? We need some lights!
What the hell is he doing? Misdirections of the technique.
Cameras! And the Frank and Happy Meal Junior Orchestra!
Frank, what the hell are you doing?
My name is Frank William Abagnale Jr. This is my story.
These people have musical instruments.
I was a millionaire twice over and half again before I was 21. I stole every nickel up. I flew over 5 million miles as a Pan Am pilot, practiced medicine at the top Atlanta hospital, and worked as a prosecutor for the state of Louisiana, all under assumed names. Mr. Hanratty here thinks he has all the facts, but only I know just how I did it. I did it in style.
Live in living color, let me take you for a ride. Yes, I'm live in living color. So sit back and let me be your TV guy.
Alright, let me get this straight. You think your life is some sort of TV special?
Honestly, has never been one of my
virtues. Virtue has never been one of your virtues.
I have a story I'd like to tell.
$1.8 million. He's a con man, plain and simple. Has been since the age of 16, when he built 20 grand from his father's mobile card just to buy presents for girls. When he got caught, his only excuse was,
I like girls.
Tell the folks here how I like girls becomes I'm wanted in 5 continents. Your ability to pull myth from the new earth is truly impressive.
After the war, my father was a GI. My mother was young and beautiful.
The people in that little French village were so happy to see Americans that they decided to put on a show for us. So they crammed 200 GIs into a tiny social hall. When the first person up on stage is your mother, she starts to dance. The men are literally holding their breath. So I turned to my buddies and I said,
I'm not leaving France without them.
I always get into trouble when I dance with you.
I interviewed both of your parents. Don't try to sell me some sentimental picture of domestic bliss.
With a special guest appearance from Playboy's Playmate of the Year, Cheryl Ann something.
I'm surprised you didn't remember my birthday. Listen, you know this son of a bitch.
Thank you, Cheryl Ann.
All right, Frank, that's enough. I know the story and I'm taking you in.
All right, Mr. Henry, I'll make you a deal. If you let me finish, I'll tell you everything. I'll even tell you how I passed the bar exam in Orleans. We owe each other that much, don't you think?
Alright, you got a deal. after that, Frank, whatever you're calling yourself these days.